Hey, fellas. Or whatever it is you want to be. All right, it's Thanksgiving. So, happy Thanksgiving to y'all. And it's not exactly a tradition, but I like to put one up on Thanksgiving Day because there's a lot of guys like me out there that couldn't care less about football. And they like having the, hey, I got a Redneck Restorations, this old truck I can wash. And this time I'm going to bring you this old truck. So the Biscayne is done. Title is in hand. It is for sale. It's up on Craigslist in Reno and Seattle and L.A. and Columbus, Ohio, of all places. I still have probably two videos I want to do with the Biscayne. And after that, it's on to Operation Krusty Truck, which that's in the... It's in here right now. Krusty's transfer case. All that there. So that's in the editor right now. But what I'm going to do now is an 82 Dodge that I only shot a little bit of footage of because I wasn't going to do the whole truck because it was get it in, get it out, get it gone. So that's what you're going to see next. So happy Thanksgiving and have a great rest of the year. Well, I wasn't going to make a video of this, but it's so Redneck Restorations that I guess I should turn the camera on. Now, I had a 1980 Chevy long bed, straight six, three on the tree that I said in a previous video that I'm not going to make any video of because it's just one that's going to go back to Ohio. Well, nothing transpired with that, and I didn't make any video of it, and I was trying to sell it here because we ran into an issue with it that we didn't want to fix. So a guy contacted me and said, hey, you want to trade? And I said, well, what do you got? And he said, well, I got this 82 Dodge short bed 4x4, runner driver. Okay, so a running 4x4 for a non-running two-wheel drive straight six, three-speed on the column. Okay, we'll do that. So it is not without issues like this. I just want to tell you that when you hit a deer and it buckles up the fender and it shoves it back that far, no amount of ball peen hammer is going to pull that dent out, as is seen by said mess. So what I have done, I have measured from that lip right there to this lip right here. That is 46 inches. On this side, same lip over there up to here is 44 inches. So this is pushed back 2 inches. All right, so if you look at the radiator support or the core support, this is flat. Goes straight across. Look at this side. The bend begins here. It's pushed back 2 inches. Same way with this on the bumper, except for the bumper is bent back. They pulled it out. They did an okay job. So I have made, I drilled two holes here. Behind this is a block of wood, about 2.5 inches deep, about 1.5 inches wide, and covers these two. There's a piece of steel behind that with the chain connected to it. And now we're going to do a little bit of body bend them back. It's not frame straightening because we don't have any frame damage. You can see right here how that's pushed up there. So we got a real close gap at the A pillar. And I don't know if it sustained any A-pillar damage. It kind of looks like it, but the door is hitting here. And I've already moved that door to, because you couldn't open it. It was, you could push the button and then you had to lift the door to get it up off the striker. So I don't have to do that now, but it's still binding there. So now we're going to wham this a few times. See if we can get some movement out of it.
First, we'll see what a tug does.
Thank you.
pretty good. Move this back about a quarter of an inch. Move this back about a half an inch. Hold this out from being pushed back in behind. I can't tell how far this moved up. I need to pull on the bottom more than the top, which means I gotta go higher with my chain.
And I think we'll bump it a little. My door opens easier. 45 5/8. Just a wee bit more, Captain. That'll do, pig. 46. It's a beautiful thing.
And here is our end result. We got a tremendous amount of gaptivity right here. Well, the buckle that used to be here is now a gap, and now there's a buckle here. Not a bad thing, not a bad thing. Because we've got another fender coming to go on here. But I was kind of hoping maybe get some A-pillar tweakage out of it. But the other truck that I went and looked at the wrecking yard, since I've turned the camera off, is the same way. It hasn't been wrecked either. And the door's real tight in the back and real tight in the front, which almost means the door has to come straight down. But the gap's pretty close on the bottom. So what do you do? What do you do? That's in, so this can come out. And that's a matter of loosening the bolts on the door and then moving it out that way, which I'll get to. But look at that. It sucked this right in. Sucked this right in. This was pushed up that way. Pulled it right back down. So, had he not beat it with a hammer, I would have done the yanking with the chain. Got that pulled back out. Then I'd have beat on it with a rubber mallet. So we're 46 inches now from the firewall to the edge of the core support. The kink here is almost non-existent. So this, it's kind of dark now, but that's going straight across. Closed up the gap of the bumper. It's a beautiful thing. I'll show you what I did. If I can get it out. Bent bolt. Like that. Block of wood. Steel behind it. Just a piece of scrap laying around. That's what done her. Cool. Time to get that fender off of there. So this is Wednesday night, and tomorrow's Thanksgiving Day. Didn't take me long to edit this. We're at 9 minutes and 15 seconds. I still got some footage on here. I don't know. You want to see a little more? All right. We'll do a little more. Now, this is just one of those things where you say, you know, I wish I had this on video. That'll do, pig. Okay, I'm doing my Mr. Heavy Chevy Chevaholic kind of videos. I just show you what I've done instead of showing you while I'm doing it. So, there's the front clip off of that Dodge. Had to pull it undercover with the reins, which are not raining right now. So, why would I take the front end off? Well, I had to put valve seals on it. That needed replaced. This thing was an absolute filthy pig. There was huge amounts of grease built up on it everywhere. So that all got pressure washed off. Had the wrong wiper motor on it. The wiper transmission bushing bearings gone on it. That all had to be done. Of course it was wrecked. Not bad, but that fender had to come off. They had welded the radiator in. There's the spots where they welded it in on both sides. That had to come out. This was all mint and bangled, as well as this part here. It was all folded back over that way. Why? I don't know. But it's all better now. Got a blue fender from the wrecking yard. Turned it white. Come on. It was bad enough trying to climb up underneath the hood on that other Dodge from years back. Amazing how it's white Dodges that I do this to. Four-wheel drive. All this wiring here for the alternator was all unwrapped. Same way with the harness over here. Well, I can't see nothing to do this. Same way with the harness over here. It wasn't a harness anymore. It was just a bunch of wires all exposed. So that had to get all wrapped up after I removed about 40 feet of excess wiring that wasn't needed. Tune up, air cleaner, correct one. What else? Oh, the exhaust over here. The butterfly for the crossover on the intake manifold. So, lots of things to have been done under here. Well worth the 45 minutes. Well, I bet you would have liked to have seen me struggle that up there by myself. Really wasn't hard because it was just the three-quarter front. Just tip it up on its nose and slide it back till the inner fender goes over the tire and pick up on the front of it and set it on the support mounts. Then put the fender on there. I think I've dropped this camera one too many times. It's going crazy, man. What are you looking at? So now it's time to get this buttoned up. I found out, even though I had this pulled out to 46 inches, at the bottom it was still pushed back an inch. Once I put the fender on here, this was way far away. Well, if you consider 1 inch way far away. The bend occurs here. Got a pry bar. Gonna come along, secured it, put some tension on it, pounded in the apex. Brought that bottom back out to where this would slide right back into place. And now I'm not pushed back into the door, because initially it was. Oh, come on. Oh, well, you get what you get. So, bolting it together. That'll move over. Progress. All together now. Okay, so you want to put the hood on an 82 Dodge Ram pickup by yourself, and you're weak and old and feeble. Here's what you do. You unbolt your hood hinge, leaving the one bolt in the forward position. Tip your hood hinge down. You'll end up with something that looks like this. Now you've got your bolt location here on your hood. Where's the back one? Little bit off. Needs to move towards the driver's side a bit. Start your rearward bolt in the hood. Of course, the front one should line up too. Not quite. And repeat for the other side. Thank you. do, pig. Prefer not to stick my head down in this guillotine. Theoretically, we're really close. But not close enough. Isn't that why they make these? According to the safety latch, it should come forward a bit. So what am I going to look at?
I'm going to look at this line. Looks pretty good. This gap right here. Looks like it might interfere. This gap over here definitely kicked over to the left a little.
So that means either this hinge has to go back or the other hinge has to go forward.
Gap here, pretty tight. Gap here, pretty far. So, hood needs to come back this way, which pulls that even tighter over there. That ain't good. But that's just the way life is. And you're just gonna have to deal with it.
So let's deal with it. So if I bring this back, that turns the hood this way, brings this into here, which is too much. So I gotta bring them both back. Oh, what fun. So I got a bunch of gap here, not much gap here. It's even too far over that way for the cowl screen. So before we do any bolt adjustments, let me do this. Not good, not enough, but better. And there's nothing you can do about that because I ain't got enough oomph. But what I have is blocks of wood. That gained me an eighth. That has lined me up with the cowl on that side, but not this side. So the hood, the cowl is wider than the hood, the cowl vent. Say, that worked splendidly. At least I thought it did. Oh, definitely pushed it over in the back. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Got a nice gap at the cowl vent. Got a wide gap here in the front. Of course, the hood's mashed right there. Gonna be. I'm still wider here than here. My gap is nice over there, so I think I'll slide it forward on this side. Yes. I could still come this way. A little more. But my line is straight on both sides. It just needs to come over that way a little more. Which might be just fine the way it is. Now the other thing I want to look at is the latch in here appears to be a little bit too far that way. So now the secondary latch does what it's supposed to. That looks like if I go straight down the hood latch. Oh, I sure hope it unlatches. Like that. Yeah, I think that's just from being crunched right there. Back needs to go down a quarter of an inch. That one's close enough to good enough. it could go down a little too. I think we're just not going to worry about it on this old beast. Good release testing. Oh, yeah. Do I even want to mess with that? I really don't. Oh yeah, I brought it down significantly. I think this one just needs the hinge to rotate downward. Alright, we'll do that. It's about that far. No, I have to bring that the rest of the way down. This side's just about perfect. I say just about because it's bent. And I am not straightening it out. Yes. Yes, enough. Yeah. Yeah. That's good. Cold start, shall we? What? No power. Why? Someone's disconnected the battery cable.
Look at the radiator support. Hark, my parts. Hello. Gotcha. Gotcha. Thank you. Bye. My parts. So I have made, I drilled two holes here. Behind this is a block of wood, about 2.5 inches wide, and about 2.5 inches deep, about 1.5 inches wide.
That's exciting.